If you go into the new year thinking, oh, it's just another year, like, this is gonna suck, it's going to suck. Hello, YouTube, it's me, it's Erin, and welcome back to my channel. This is the first video of 2018, so I just wanted to say Happy New Year. This video is actually going up on New Year's Day as you're watching it right now, but right now when I'm filming it, it's actually the day before New Year's Eve, and it's actually snowing outside, which is really exciting. It's really getting me in the mood. But for today's video, I want to talk about how to make 2018 the best year yet in your life, and how to really motivate yourself and get yourself prepared to have the best year yet. I'm not saying the best year ever, because I want every single year to slowly but surely improve and just get better and better. I just want to improve myself as I go, but I just wanted to make a really quick video on how I'm preparing myself and how you can prepare yourself to make 2018 the best year yet. But if you're new here, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe down below for new videos. You can also turn on my post notifications, because my video schedule is Monday, Wednesday, and Saturdays, but I really want to get more into vlogging. So whenever I have a vlog, I'm just going to be posting sporadically on the days that I don't normally upload. So I'm thinking the video tomorrow will be my New Year's Eve vlog, but I'm trying to get more into vlogging, so definitely turn on your post notifications so that you're notified whenever I post a sporadic vlog. So without further ado, let's just get started. I think the first step on how to make 2018 the best year yet is to really reflect on 2017 and kind of how it was for you, if it was the best, if it was the worst. For me, it wasn't the greatest year. I went through so many struggles, leaving my school and taking a semester off. I just went through a lot of really big changes for me in 2017, and it really was a really big year of growth, but it was not the best year for me. So that's why I'm really determined to make 2018 a lot better, and I already have so many goals for it. But I just think it's really important to start off 2018 with sitting down and writing out and just really reflecting about what 2017 was for you. I recently watched Kayla Nicholson's video about this, and she made a really good point about to write about and think about the role that you played in your 2017 and how it went. Because a lot of the time you're thinking back about how 2017 went and you're like, oh, it was such a bad year, I hated it. But what role did you play in it? Were you the one making yourself stagnant? Were you the one negatively thinking about your life? Were you the one taking the big role and really making the year what it was? I think it's important to not place the blame on others and to place the blame on yourself too. If you didn't move as much as you wanted in your career, if you didn't move as much as you wanted with your friends, your family, I think it's important to take your action in it. Like I said, I think it's just important to get a piece of paper, start a journal, get a piece of scrap paper that you can throw out afterwards, and just really write down what 2017 meant to you and what you did in the year and what you really think you could have done differently. But I really think reflection is the most important step in how to make 2018 the best year yet. My next tip for how to make 2018 the best year is to start writing down your goals for 2018. I'm not really a resolution person, because I think they can sometimes be a little bit cheesy, but I'm definitely a goal person. Me and Jamie the other day actually sat down together and we wrote out our 2018 goals. For example, a few of my 2018 goals was that I want to hit 1,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel. I also wrote that I want to get really great grades at my new school. I also wrote that I wanted to go on a road trip out of state, and I also wrote that I wanted to travel out of the country. Simple things that you know you could accomplish. Just simple things that will motivate you every day to get out of bed and work towards those goals. They could be cheesy things or really easily able to achieve things if you want to, but I just said things that were a little bit out of my reach that I really had to work for that would really motivate me to get out of bed in the morning and really work towards my goals. The next thing I would recommend is to do a bucket list. This kind of goes along with the goals that I said before, but me and Jimmy wrote a bucket list together of things that we want to accomplish in 2018 together. You could do it with a brother, a sister, your mom, your dad, your best friend, even your grandma. Just write a bucket list of things that you want to accomplish so that you can check them off throughout the year as we did them. So me and Jimmy wrote a few random things, like go out of the state just together on a vacation, go to a concert together. We said we wanted to film more videos on my channel together. Just little things, once again, like I said, that will motivate you and really get you excited for 2018. Another tip that I would have for how to make 2018 the best year yet is to really just get a planner and just write down things that you have to look forward to and start planning things. I think it's really important to live in the present and not in the future, but just to get yourself excited for 2018 and really make it a good year and not something that you're really dreading. I think it's important to start off the new year thinking about things that you have to look forward to in the future. I think it's really important to live in the present and not in the future, but I think it's really cool to get a planner and just write out different events that you have coming up in the future, things that you're really excited about, your birthday, a friend's birthday, if you have a trip coming up, or if you want to plan a trip coming up. Just the tiniest things that could really get you motivated and get you in the right mindset to have 2018 be the best year yet, I think is really important. And planners are awesome for organization. The next step I would have to make 2018 the best year yet is to really, really, really look into the power of manifestation and law of attraction. For me, I wrote a list of things that I wanted to manifest and things that I wanted to attract into my life in the month of December, because I really got into it in December. And surprisingly, I actually manifested all the things I wrote down, which is insane. I really want to check out the documentary Law of Attraction on Netflix. I've heard about it on Netflix. I'm not sure if it's still up, but I really want to get more into manifesting. So I really want to write a list of all the things that I want to manifest in 2018. It's different than your goals and your bucket list, because it's things that you want to attract into your life, because you really need to open up your heart and your mind and your spirit to getting these things. Because if you close all the doors, there's no way that these things can get in to you. I've just gotten really into the power of manifestation, the law of attraction, and I really saw it work in action in the month of December, so I'm really excited to be manifesting more things into my life in the future. Another way that I think that you can make 2018 the best year yet is to really pick up a new hobby. Not really a hobby, but I'm really trying to teach myself new languages, so I've been really using the app Duolingo. I talked about it in my What's on My iPad video that I did in my Vlogmas. I want to do a more sit-down What's on My iPad soon, so definitely expect that in the future. Just like anything, you can pick up scrapbooking, you can pick up writing your own book, you can pick up starting up a YouTube channel like I did last year. I just think it's really important to start up a new hobby to just get your mind going, and that kind of goes along with reading more books and trying to grow your mind. I really think it's important not to stay stagnant, especially that's one thing I think a lot of people have, is just staying comfortable and staying in friendships and relationships and hobbies and just a lifestyle that they think they're really comfortable in. I think it's really important to take the active steps to really grow and take the steps to improve yourself whenever you can. Another tip for how to make 2018 the best year yet is to really start journaling. That's one thing me and Jamie both said that we wanted to start doing this year, is to just sit down, whether it be in the day or the night, and write out what happened in the day. And you can have another journal too where you write out your goals and just how you're feeling, just to keep track of your emotions. I think it's really, really cool to look back on journals and just see how you're feeling and how much better you're doing now, and see if you hadn't accomplished your goals then but you have now, just to see your own personal growth. I think that's really cool, and journaling is something that I definitely want to get more into. My last tip for how to make 2018 the best year yet is to really just believe that it's going to be the best year yet. If you go into the new year thinking, oh, it's just another year, like this is gonna suck, it's going to suck. Kind of like with the manifestation and law of attraction before. And you come into 2018 with a bad mindset or a negative mindset, negative things will attract to you like a magnet, and they will find their way into your life. It sounds stupid, but just believing that 2018 is going to be the best year yet will really, really affect you. Take the positive strides to hang out with your friends, your family, do good in school, do good at work, start up a new hobby, just start journaling, start reading, teaching yourself things, really just bettering yourself and improving your life, and everything will fall into place, because the saying goes, your dreams don't work unless you do, so it's important to take the strides and steps to improve yourself in any aspect that you can. But thank you so much for watching today's video. Don't forget to give this video a like if you liked it. Don't forget to also comment down below your resolutions or your goals and what you want to accomplish for 2018, because trust me, I have so many things that I want to do. Also, let me know if you have any video requests for 2018, because I'm already filming so many videos and I cannot wait for all the content I'm going to be doing. I start up school this January, so I'm going to have so many college-related videos coming your way, so definitely get excited for that. Also, don't forget to subscribe and turn on your post notifications, because, like I said, I have so many amazing videos coming your way this month and the rest of this year. But thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye! I want to pretend I'm at the North Pole, tanning the heat and doing ice cold.